Today is April 7th, 2016, and yes, we are indeed running out of 2016. We still have 8 more months to go. The fact remains that time is moving on with or without us. I live in a neighborhood where I see African American, poor African American, poor black people trying to get something for nothing, gambling on the lottery. We made a campaign against the lottery because even though you see the lottery is supported by poor people of This is me. So people with that same hue, support the liberal agenda. I mean, who do you think brought the lottery into the neighborhoods? We have nothing here. We have nothing in our neighborhoods. But Planned Parenthood is there. It's close. I don't know where Planned Parenthood is, but these are the people who support Planned Parenthood with their nice pink colors, blue. You know what Planned Parenthood is? It's where they murder babies. But these people and their agenda have been able to convince black people that it's something that's worthy of support. I just did a video with Hillary Clinton in it, and she's the one that came with the crime bill. She's the one that, do your own history. Go look it up. You're the one that supports her. I'm not going to try to not convince you to support Hillary Clinton or not to support Planned Parenthood, because I'm not you. But in the neighborhood that I live in, it's me. These single mothers encourage their children to play basketball, play football for the plantation, the ACAA. Everybody gets paid. Listen to this mug. All he did was make a shot.
Well, when you're talking about one shining moment, Chris Jenkins just provided one here tonight.
To provide someone with amusement or enjoyment. Receive as a guest and provide them with food and drink. Give attention or consideration to. All right, you're being entertained with this crap. This is what makes you so happy. Look at this shit. Guess who's not getting paid?
Well, when you're talking about one shining moment, Chris Jenkins just provided one here tonight.
Oh my God. Celebration. I've never seen one player so excited in my life as you. Man, I'm just so blessed to be a part of this great university and part of this great team.
Your ass is not a part of that university. You're being used by the university. Billions and billions of dollars being made. This is what young black boys are dreaming about doing. Make your own damn video. Make your own sport. Black people own nothing. Black people own, as a group, whatever black is, you own nothing. You think you're a part of that university? Wait till I'm gonna follow you, and I'm gonna add this to the video when they put your ass in jail. I hope that they don't, but you know, it's stupid.
And Ryan Archidiakono found me right in stride, and I won two steps, and it was going up.
Only 4.7 seconds left when you guys took the ball out of the mound. What play was described? How did it evolve?
I mean, we just went out press offense, and Ryan Archidiakono caught the ball and dribbled up the court, and I was able to get his vision, and he fouled me.
That, ladies and gentlemen, was a basketball shot. I used to shoot them mugs from fucking half court. I'm in this place, we're doing a finale. But words have no meaning these days because they use one word for everything. You know, like joy. It's joy. They took the detergent out of it. Love is ambiguous. I love those cookies. Ooh, I love that car. How can one word have so many meanings? But they celebrate this kind of crap. They celebrate the lottery.
Hey man, we just trying to be legendary.
Definitely, you guys are playing your best basketball down the stretch. You're number one in early February. What did it take to get back to the top ranking of the national championship?
Just hard work and dedication. You know, a lot of teams and a lot of programs don't really respect, you know, our body of work because we haven't gone far in the tournament. But, you know, this is a great step in the right direction.
You hugged about thousands of people after that shot, including your mother. What did you say to mom?
I said, what can they say now? You know, they know. This is so stupid.
All you is going to be a big fat offensive lineman. So stupid, man. What is that shit going to do for you when you're 50 years old? Like me. 56 years old. And then put myself in it because I'm into books, reading. Knowledge, education, that's not anything that I think I deserve to be on TV for or deserve to be celebrated for. But this is who I am right here. That's who I used to be. They don't give a fuck about you. Where you gonna pick your check up?
It's not in me in my life. You know, somebody had the nerve to tell my mom when I was younger that all I would be when I grow up was a fed offensive lineman. Well, that fed offensive lineman is a national champion in college.
Yeah. Go try to buy some fucking snickerdoodles with that shit. Go buy some motherfucking. Which I'm sure you're a nice man. You've just been indoctrinated. That's all. This is where they come from. This. Oh, no, let's do this one. Let's do this one. Yes. This is the last one. This is your black woman here. And look at them. Look who claps for them. Them. They love you, motherfuckers.
Oh, God. My next guest made a name for herself as one of the baddest girls on reality TV. But now she's weighing in on The Crazy. In her new series, please welcome co-host of Crazy Talk, Tanisha Tanisha.
I don't have words. I'm gonna let her do the talking.
You know what? First of all, it's nice to turn just a reality moment into a reality. God, favor.
When you see one of them, co-host Crazy Talk, all right. Let's look up the word crazy, because I think maybe some of y'all don't know what it means. Mentally deranged, you stupid motherfucker. Mentally deranged, especially as manifested in a wild or aggressive way. Foolish. Appearing absurdly out of place or in an unlikely position. Crazy. Look up these words sometimes. Even with all their ambiguity. Ambiguity. They still convey a certain connotation. Uncertainty or inexactness of meaning in language, a lack of decisiveness, or resulting from a failure. They call this a queen. They call this beautiful. Look at this shit on my hair. Not even her hair. And then her. Let's look up bombastic. That's what she is. I think that. High sounding, but with little meaning, inflated, bombastic.
I don't like when I say that, Steve, but it is what it is. Hard work. They think it's fun. It looks fun on the outside, but it's work, honey. I'm missing meals a little bit. I'm missing dates, all kinds of stuff, but I ask for it. I want to do work. Let's get it.
Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven, and all these things, the coin, will be added into you. You Philistine. Look up Philistine. Sorry. The person who is hostile in different culture and the art, or who has no understanding. Philistine, motherfucker. A member of a non-Semitic people of ancient southern Palestine who came into conflict with the Israelites. According to the Bible, the Philistines from whom the country of Palestine took its name came from Crete and settled in southern coastal plains of Canaan in the 12th century. There's a Philistine right there. He's Philistine, man.
Get the coin, get the coin, get the coin.
Yes, Steve!
That's really good. All right, tell us about this new beat that you got.
Crazy Talk is an epic show. We're celebrating crazy. We're embracing crazy. All of those crazy.
Celebrating.
It was a party for 30 minutes. We celebrated some of your favorite stars.
I don't look at fucking TV. I just make fun of it. And these dumb asses that they have on it. These fuckers, the motherfucking.
On the show, I'm talking about love and hip-hop, basketball, wives. Oh, we love. We are obsessed with Chef Gordon Ramsay. You know I love my food. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Yes, you know I'm a winner. You know it, Steve.
I see it. Yes. I love you. I ain't gonna lie to you.
We gotta go eat.
I've watched it several times.
It's on Fleek.
It's got so much social media buzz. Spin-off. What makes that show so
Steve, it's real. It's raw. We want to watch real people, like people from the hood. You want to see Pookie make it. So when you watching Pookie from down the block on TV, you like, yes, Pookie, yes, yes, Pookie, yes. That's how it is. You see your own make it.
I'm watching it.
One of the things you have to understand about these mugs, the black woman is the leader, so-called black community. And look at these motherfuckers. They always have on some naked shit. Half-exposed, lost women of Zion. Look it up. All your secret parts will be exposed. Your tinkling of your feet with your heels, and your damn nails. So stupid, man. They don't love you. Yahshua loves you. But you don't love him. You've chosen.
Cause first of all, I gotta pay attention to what she says. DBJ, I want to go through
the DBJ. That's right. Something doing it, CBJ. And the BK. She always with the BK.
That's it. I got it. It's DBJ has the most amazing life of anybody I've ever seen.
Definitely.
Okay, the Real Housewives is returned. Well, what's your thoughts on the demon will do their best to resemble the demon that indwells them. For those of you who are connoisseurs of these, you can have them. For the rest of the people that may be listening, when you see one of these, do not make eye contact. Look down at their very nice shoes and try to get out with your life. These are the Olivia Popes. These are the Delilahs.
They'll take your hair, cut it off, and cut it on their bit. Oh, Heavenly Father.
making headlines, kicking Portia in the stomach.
And the event turns to the mat. Now, I'm a fan of Portia, and I like I happen to actually like all the ladies. But I didn't know Cynthia was gangsta like that. What? She done kicking in the stomach? Not even in the arm, the stomach? Oh, that's personal. You kick me in the stomach, we gonna have a problem. That's personal, see? Oh, no, honey. Not the stomach.
So, if you get kicked in the stomach, that's personal.
That's personal. In the belly, with the ass.
God, I wish I had signed.
Really? Yes, I love. Yes, look. You can smell. You can feel. I can feel.
Come on, get your
hands. Come on, what you mean? Yes. I want this one. Yes.
I love you. I never met you.
Now, that's one of the things what I was saying about the word love. It has too many meanings. Love shouldn't have this many meanings. For the love of God, rich and true. An elusive term for homosexualized make love, not for love of money. Love worthy. I think you got that.
Up next, Tanisha's gonna get to know these guys a little bit better, and one of them is gonna be taking her out. Stay with us.
Hey, Tanisha, I'm Farias, novice manager from New York City, and I'm New York City. I'm funny, somewhat nerdy, and a really great listener.
Okay.
Well, that's good. That's good. She's damn sure gonna be.
Yes. So will.
Alex.
Lisa, how you doing?
Yes, Alex. I'm sorry, Steve. Something just happened.
I'm Alex, 30-year-old ER doctor, New York City.
Ooh, he makes money.
Laid back. I work hard. Try not to take myself too seriously.
Okay. Tanisha, what's your first question for us?
I have to ask, all right, Fariyaz? You seem like a nice guy, but do you have a record or any type of baby mama trauma at all?
No drama. No record. Only a 790 credits.
Yeah! 790. Steve, I like that. Yeah, impressive, Steve. Thank you. Alex. Oh, Lord. Alex, if you could turn me into a dessert. Yes, honey. What would I be?
If you were to be a dessert, I would say you would be sardine cake with anchovy frosting and some type of rotten chicken top. And I would just motherfucking throw your ass the fuck out. If you ever got anywhere near me, that's what I would do with you if you were a dessert.
Snatch a typical dessert. Probably make you French toast. Put you on the stove. Warm you up. About that spatula. Turn you over. Put my syrup all over you.
I'm just trying to show you how you are.
Alex, I'll let you write your own questions next time. I'm doing your questions for you. What you asked? She rate me at 9 out of 10. I like to put my lady's needs ahead of mine, so I'm gonna try new things to keep you satisfied.
You're so fucking stupid. Your lady needs fucking hair weaves and
Crazy talk ass weekday.
Don't look at it. This chick right here is going to be saying how white women are copying black women. Don't believe anything she says. Or don't believe in doing that.
I want to talk to you about a new topic based on a tweet I posted on Instagram.
So the tweet says, I have no take note of how she's throwing up the sixes. It's like they call it the okay sign, but she's letting everybody know she's available.
For a black man who slanders black women while praising white women for their black features. Now, I stand by every word I said, but I do want to clarify because I want to give those who comment and question on Instagram the benefit because I didn't post all the tweets.
Remember, where there's one, there's no fun. And remember, you simp as a fucking shit wouldn't give you the time of day. Unless you had money.
To this post. This all began when I saw an article online that said something along the lines of 2014 being the era of big butts, thanks to Kim K. And now 2015, Kylie Jenner has started the trend of big butts. Really? She started. So I'm going to read off some of the things I tweeted leading up to this post just so you can understand it better in context. I said, so big lips are a trend now thanks to girls like Kylie Jenner. We'll tell that to all the little black girls who are getting bullied for them in elementary school and in high school. And definitely don't forget to tell that to the same girls when that bullying turned into sexualization with the nickname DSL. Y'all know that. They get credit for buying our butts, our lips, our styles, yet black women are still being disrespected for the same features and more. They love everything about a black woman, except of course, the black part. And then I said, I have no respect for a black man who slanders black women while praising white women for their black features.
I have no respect for you. With your, I hope that's your hair. I remember black women didn't have hair like that, but I'm going to take a guess and think that it's a hair weave. And even if your hair is real. Who are black women to talk about features and appropriate when they lead the league and buying other people's hair and pasting, plastering this shit all over their hair. And flipping it, and running whatever.
Said, I think it's more than obvious that my beef is not with all black men or white girls who have full lips and big butts and are curvy. My issue is with the black men who disrespect black women, and then on top of that, praise white women for the black features that they paid for. And I know there's something else I need to clarify because people question me on this again and again, and that's what are black features? Now, obviously, black people do not own big butts, we don't have no lips copyrighted, and not all black women are curvy. However, when you look back to those super racist cartoons from back in the day, how were we drawn? What did our lips look like? What did our butts look like? When they painted their faces in blackface, what did the makeup or their lips look like? And when we're being copied and ridiculed for our body shape, how do they go about that? Do we own these features? Of course not, but if a large percentage of us didn't have these characteristics, we wouldn't be stereotyped in this way. Our features were not exaggerated in these cartoons the way that they were, and because of that I'm damn sure I'm not about to praise white women for these features they paid for when us who have these features naturally are still being condemned, and I will never respect a black man who does just that. So when I say black features, I'm not just saying they took our lips, our butts, or whatever. I'm saying they're mimicking all of the things that they belittled us with and realistically still do. But you know, this isn't going to be a video of me going in on the Kylie Jenners and the Kim K's and the Iggy Azaleas and the Miley Cyruses. I wish I could, but I cannot change their mindsets. Nor do I really want to make a video for them when I know they're not going to watch it, and I know that it's not benefiting my people to make something for them. This is to show my concern with all the black men who don't see even the slightest problem with this. The majority of people who question my posts on Instagram were either not black or
all the black women who watch Scandal, the number one show of black women. All the black women who wear hair, all the black women who say, I'm looking for a good black. I want you motherfuckers to tell me, because I'm pretty sure I'm not a good one. But that's cool, because I'm not looking for love. She's very beautiful, to look at. But look at her throwing up the 666.
She's not a woman of the Most High.
That's fine. Be whatever you want. But I'm just telling you, brothers. Don't waste your time trying to please her. Do not.
Now, real quick. If you are not a black man or a black woman, you are very much open to sharing your opinions. However, if you're not a black man or a black woman, you're simply someone on the outside looking in. You're like the white people who complain about the racism against them. I'm not saying you don't have the right to talk about it. I'm not saying that you haven't experienced some shit. I'm just saying it's like you complaining about a splinter and I'm walking around with a knife in my back. Just sit back and chill because this one is not for you. My biggest concern with the black men who tried to argue that my tweet was wrong was that they completely disregarded the black men slandering and disrespecting black women part and only acknowledged the part about white women having black features. Really? You're just gonna ignore that? You're gonna act like it's not an issue the way black women are treated? That's cool. That's fine. Actually, no. It's not.
Lynch is the attorney general. Condoleezza Rice, the mayor of Baltimore, the mayor of Detroit. Black women are not suffering. All you do is fucking bitch and moan and cry because you want more and more and more and more. It's fine. I'm happy with my life.
Black women are hands down the most disrespected group of people on this planet. We're talked down to every single day, whether it be in music, in videos, in movies, on the internet, in the streets, wherever. We're to be disrespected by the very boys we raised, to be disrespected by the boys we grew up with, to be disrespected by the boys who will become men and possibly have black daughters of their own, no matter how far outside you your children will be black, and even more so to be disrespectful when we're the ones who are loved and defend you when all others don't. They don't love you when you're not dribbling the ball or selling records and making the millions. The media slanders black men like it's nothing. Law enforcement and the justice system don't even acknowledge that you're human. And who are the main ones in the street demanding justice for you? Who's teaching you how to take care of yourself and telling you to do your homework and getting on with fuck up? Who's looking to you for protection while you look to us for nurture? Your black mothers, your black sisters, your black daughters, and you have the nerve to talk down to us? You have the nerve to say you'd never date a black woman? You have the nerve to say black women are ugly? You have the nerve to say you hate when girls wear their natural hair? And don't even get started on the way you got to talk about dark skin. Now, my intent here is not to throw shade at black men, and I'm definitely not going to say that all black men disrespect black women. Because speaking in general within the black community, the way black men treat black women is just atrocious. I get so many compliments from guys outside of my race, and I'm sure plenty of you ladies.
She's very beautiful. Look at her eyes. Eyes, flawless to look at. But the second she opens her mouth, that's what's undoing you. It's not that you're not beautiful. You're beautiful like a snake. You're Jezebel. But yeah, you're beautiful. You have a pleasant voice. I just don't like what you have to say, but you know. I wouldn't hurt you. Yo, no, I would never date you. Let's close this out.
And it's so sad because we should not have to look outside of our race for recognition or acknowledgement or a damn compliment. And for the younger black.
Okay, what did she just say? What the fuck did she just say? Outside of our race for recognition or acknowledgement or a damn compliment. Is that all you give a fuck about? You need to stop talking.
Younger black guys who throw compliments my way, they usually say some bullshit like, damn, shorty, you kind of dazzle. It's not a conflict. But you know what's the saddest thing about all of this? No matter what, no matter how many times you guys disrespect us or step on us, we'll always be by your side. Regardless of any other factors, we're in this together because none of us can get rid of our black.
All right, that was her. With the fifth age in the middle, she's not a stupid ass. She's sending out all the signals. But this is her. Go follow her. I won't be following her. What is one? There's no fun. With his two.
My next guest made a name for himself as one of the baddest girls.
With his two, you better run. What is more than three, I will not. These bugs are serious about it. And then there's your simp right there. He does try to throw some knowledge, but anyhow. Don't believe me. Don't believe anybody else. Do your own research, make some videos. Good night.